While consumer electronics makers and broadcasters are fixated on 4K as the next big thing in television, Japanese broadcaster NHK is looking even further into the future and developing an 8K system. To give you an idea of how high a resolution 8K is, this red box represents standard definition video. As we pull out, we see the gold box, which is 720p HD. Then the green box, which is full HD, or the format that most of us consume our content in today. The blue box represents the next generation television sets and content production, 4K, or Ultra HD, which is 4 times full HD. If we keep going, we see the purple box, which represents NHK's super high vision 8K content. The resolution is 7,680 by 4,320 pixels, or about 100 times standard definition. While the technical hurdles mean that NHK won't be able to bring 8K into homes until 2020, the reason the group is working on the technology is simple.
And 8K is the ultimate resolution for human eyes. So 8K is enough for human eye, and no more resolution is needed.
Uncompressed, the amount of data flowing from an 8K camera is an astounding 144 gigabits per second at 120 hertz. NHK, though, isn't only researching a display and camera to capture in 8K, but also encoding and transmission. It's using the new standard called HEVC, or H.265, which needs about half the bitrate of H.264 to transmit the same video quality. HEVC is currently being used in 4K applications. While 8K to the home is a ways off, NHK plans to produce test broadcasts in the next few years.
We plan to start test broadcasting by 2016. It is a test broadcasting. And some people can see the broadcast, 8K broadcast, in some places, not home, but in a theater or some kind of places. And by 2020, we plan to realize in home, people can see this 8K resolution.
At NHK's first U.S. demonstration of the technology at NAB in Las Vegas, the results were impressive. The picture was crisp and clear when displayed on the enormous displays at the company's booth. If NHK's 8K is fully realized, it'll be a long time coming. The group started researching the technology in 2002, when many of us were still watching television on standard definition CRT TVs. At NAB 2014 in Las Vegas, Nick Barber, IDG News Service.